Hey, my lovely filmmakers. I'm recording this from my living room. As you can see, living room doesn't look too much different from my classroom. I have a lot of books, I have a lot of movies over there. I live with a scientist, so there are bones scattered above me. Today I'm going to talk to you guys about gangster films. We're going to be discussing the six major American films. These are films that that we really, as Americans, that we gave birth to, rather than comedies and romance and stuff like that. Other countries kind of led the way in that too, but these are genres that were born and bred here. Those genres are gangster, film noir, I'm gonna look down and read my notes a couple of times, sci-fi, horror, western, and musicals. Today we're just gonna be talking about gangster films. You guys have probably seen a gangster film or two. They have a lot of common elements. Not every gangster movie is alike, but I'm just gonna talk to you about a little bit about the basics of gangster movies and kind of where they came from, why that kind of movie came up and became popular. It is gangster movies, their plots are rooted really in the American dream. You have a person who, you know, comes up in usually hard circumstances. Either they're a minority or they're an immigrant or something. They start off poor, and they, through like a lot of hard work and ambition and courage and just a little bit of disregard for the law, they rise up into power and riches, which is basically, you know, what we're told as Americans, that it doesn't matter what class we're born to in life. If we work hard enough, we can have everything we want. So a gangster usually does that. He's a hero who's an outsider who lives by his wits. It's usually a man, that's why I keep saying him, and is willing to break the rules. There were two events in history that really made the gangster genre in movies popular. There was. In 1919, the 18th Amendment was passed, which prohibited alcohol. We've talked a little bit about this in class. So that one law created a lot of criminals, because, especially for Irish, Italian, and Jewish immigrants, saw an opportunity to make some real cash, because it's supply and demand. There are a lot of people who wanted to drink. They were willing to break the law. They did. So we had these gangs that would sell bootleg alcohol. And it kind of, that law also created a criminal of the common person. Let's say you're just a regular person and you've had a really hard day at work and you want to drink. Having a beer after work made you a criminal. So the average person was able to identify with this, with a lawbreaker as a main character. Then they had the stock market crash in 1929. Which you would think would be unrelated. However, it was really depressing. America lost all its money. People were depressed. They wanted an escape from reality. They also suffered a distrust in authority, because America pretty much crashed. So their heroes became essentially the anti-heroes. And I'll tell you what an anti-hero is in a little while. But they would go to movies and, you know, they were poor and feeling beat and downtrodden and upset with the government, upset with authority that had failed them. And they see this person who rises to the top and isn't afraid to break the law and has a lot of money. But then, if you guys recall what the Hays Code was, the Hays Code was established in it came out in 1930, but it wasn't really enforced until 1934, which was during the Great Depression. It was a list of morals that said what could and could not be in a film. What could not be in a film was pretty much every element that goes in a good gangster movie. There could not be any illegal activity, so no drug use, no alcohol abuse, no sex, and no violence. No violence. That's the heart of every gangster movie, is that they're good and violent. And also, it was the end of an age where a gangster movie main character could be sympathized with. They can't win at the end. And according to the Hays Code, a lawbreaker must be punished at the end. So usually after the Hays Code, any gangster movie involved a gangster who was crushed by authority, either police or possibly by other gangsters, but the moral of the story being is that if you broke the law, you would ultimately be destroyed. That was the good must triumph over evil, had to be the ultimate message. So this changed a lot of gangster movies before, in the very beginning, before the Hays Code, like in the early 30s and late 20s, gangster movies were violent and had sex and drug use and stuff, and then they didn't. What they interpreted as bad behavior had to be condemned. Most gangsters are killers, but they mostly just kill other bad guys. But then there comes in typical gangster movie plots, there comes this turn where before they have like their big epiphany that they've been living the wrong kind of life all their lives, good people around them start dying. Everything starts to fall apart. Everything that they've built starts tumbling down, and it's not just bad guys that they have to kill or something like that. And usually the gangster dies before they can turn themselves around. So I talked a little bit about what an anti-hero is. Actually, I didn't tell you at all what an anti-hero is. So you might be able to figure out just from the word itself. So a hero is usually like this valiant, honorable, law-abiding person like Superman. An anti-hero is a main character who's unconventional and driven by ambition, usually a need to prove himself. He is not exactly a sympathetic character, and he usually has a tragic flaw that brings him down. The gangster, the anti-hero, usually has a sidekick who humanizes him. It could be someone from his old neighborhood who he knew as a kid, could be a wife, could be like a child that they have. Sometimes towards the end of the movie, this is a character who betrays the gangster and is his tragic undoing in the end. The antagonists, the person who opposes the main character, are usually either law enforcement or other gangsters. The cops are almost always, I don't know if you've noticed this, usually criminals themselves. The setting is where the crime is. So it's almost always the city. There was one gangster movie I saw called Lawless that was set in the country because it was like in the mountains in the 1930s because they were bootleggers. But that aside, it's usually set in a city. There's a dog barking over there or something. You're going to get a lot of my household during these lessons. Anyway, that is enough for today. Thursday, I'll post another video talking about film noir. I'm going to have some questions for you posted online at the end of this video. I hope you guys are doing all right. Bye-bye.